Well, thank you very much for allowing me to present Ivenzis today. Ivenzis is a French-American company which is headquartered in Paris in France. Our mission is to develop innovative treatment, non-viral gene therapy for treatment of eye disease. This is our business strategy. The hope is to be able to deliver this treatment for a long duration of time, and to do that we have our own proprietary device, which is electrotransfection. The company, the management team is a small team with extensive experience in ophthalmology. I'm sure you recognize some of us. The technology was developed by Dr. Francine Béard-Cohen in Paris, who is a retina specialist, which I'm sure you know as well. So today we know that for treatment of eye disease, especially for retina, there are several approaches. You can do intravitreal injections with repeated injections. There are ocular implants, which works, but with some side effects. We have systemic administration with probably some issues with compliance. And lately, we have been developing a lot of viral vector gene therapy, we heard this morning already. Many of them, they work, but there are issues due to compliance, side effect, and other issues. So Ivenzis technology, the idea behind is that we are developing plasmid that we are encoding to produce human therapeutic proteins. We are injecting this plasmid directly in the ciliary muscles, in the ciliary muscles, using a little device that we have developed, which is combining an electro device put on the eyes and an e-port, which is a generator, which allows the electroporation or electrotransfection. By doing that, the protein will be produced directly in the vitreous or in the choroid or in the anterior segment. And basically, we are transforming the ciliary muscles in its own factory, biofactory. Of course, what we want to accomplish here is to be able to have sustained delivery of a protein over time. The indication we are targeting first the non-infection uveitis to validate the platform, and we're actually already in the clinic. The second project we are planning to go in the clinic in the next 2 years is the RP indication for retinitis pigmentosa, independent of gene mutation. And of course, we're going to look at wet AMD and dry AMD and glaucoma as a second tier. So to validate this platform, what did we do? We tested the concept in multiple animal models, in rats, rabbits, and non-human primates, with several proteins. First question, are we able to produce any type of protein? And as you can see on the right-hand side, we have been able to produce a series of proteins using encoding plasmid. Then the second question was, are we able to deliver them in the vitreous, which we were able to do. And we had, in this animal model, we were able to demonstrate safety, and we had a durability for up to 9 months, and we were able to measure the proteins directly in the vitreous. So we were pretty pleased with these results. We have these two programs. One is a protein, a fusion protein, that we're developing for non-infection uveitis, and also an iron chelator for RP. So for the non-infection uveitis, again, we are in clinical phase 2 right now. We have tested the protein, which is a fusion protein, using the electrotransfection in several animal models, including the EIU model and EAU models. And we were able to demonstrate protection of the retinal tissue as well as diminution in scores. That study is ongoing right now. The clinical trial is ongoing right now in Europe, in France, and in the UK. It's a safety dose escalating study. We have 6 patients enrolled, and so far we had no safety issue. Of course, we cannot report anything on safety. Our goal is to start the clinical trial in the US end of Q1 next year, after we file the IND here in the US. The program, which I was mentioning, is for retinitis pigmentosa. It's a protein, an iron chelator, pre-potent. We have demonstrated in multiple animal models the ability to protect the photoreceptor, especially in the light model, as well as protecting the function, measuring ERG. It's an interesting approach because, of course, everybody thinks about dry AMD, so that's something to be considered as well. So this was a summary of a technology, an opportunity for us to, if you can be creative, you can produce any kind of protein if you think about, as long as you can, you know, produce them and encode your plasmid, inject them in the ciliary muscle, transforming the ciliary muscle into its own biofactory, and targeting multiple diseases. And we have a pretty good board backed by investors and also independent members that you probably recognize. I think that's it. Thank you very much.